Danbury Mints, 1956 Buick. There we go. Roadmaster Riviera four-door hardtop. Look at this model. Look at this model. Is this just off the hook or what? You know, we see a lot of coupes. We see a lot of hot rods. We see a lot of cars that, I don't know, that seem to be a surefire thing for a lot of collectors because they're two-door, because they're convertibles, because they are hot rods. When you see something like this, the top-of-the-line car from Buick in that year, just a beautiful four-door hardtop. Look at the lines of this thing. This model actually got my heart racing. I know people say that a lot. When I took it out of the box, I was just knocked over by it because it is just so beautifully done, so carefully done. That's the thing I like the most. And they put some technology into this model, and it does things that models in larger scales wish they could do. And that's kind of been a hallmark of these guys. I've seen a lot of their stuff over the past few years, and it's just, it gets me every time. Of course, everything opens on the car. You have to be kind of careful. You don't want to put too much strain on anything. All four doors. Pop this. Get that open. Get that open. And, of course, the trunk. That's a full-on display piece right there. there's a lot going on there. And these guys are car guys. You can see it. You can see in the type of detail that they lavish on this thing and the way they do it. They just don't give things a lick and a promise. They really go crazy with it. Here, check out the engine. This is really kind of neat stuff. Of course, that's the 322 nail head. Wish I had more light to show you this. We're working on a pretty trick camera setup. Hopefully in the next couple of weeks we'll get that done. Take my word for it, everything is in there. All of the hoses, all of the wiring, fan belt, all of the markings, even the different colors and textures of black. Of course, photo-etched grill. Look at that beauty. Look at that little airplane on the hood, lensing, the bomb sights. Ah, just everything you would imagine could be done right is done right on this thing. Look at that beautiful wheel cover, the Buick center. Of course, the correct rim color. And then we get to the interior. And this is just, this is where the model really takes off. These had some interesting, you know, everything with GM had a kind of a trademark name. This is called Cordovine. How about that? Cordovine and vinyl. And it was just, it was apparently really desirable stuff. And they've done such an outrageous job here. It's got such a great texture on the seats. Carpeted floor, beautifully done door panels. It's amazing. Again, were I to build this model, were any of us to build this model, we would have to spend weeks to achieve this level of finesse. Look at that trunk matter, beautifully laid in there. And of course, it is textile. There's the striker plate for the locks, the spare tire, which is removable, and it's a steely. I mean, that is the real deal. It doesn't get better than that. This is amazing, amazing stuff, guys. Of course, Danbury's known for doing really good work. Chassis fully detailed. It's not necessarily overly done, but you do have the e-brake wiring here. How cool is that? How cool is that? It's on the market for $129. It is still available. And of course, if you want Danbury, you have to go to Danbury. DanburyMint.com. It's a beautiful, beautiful piece. Very excited to see them doing images that might not be surefire hits. They're not coupes, they're not convertibles, they're not hot rods, though they do those models. They do something like this, and you get the real car guys, guys of a certain age, of a certain collecting taste, and they go bananas on these things. Good work, Danbury. Keep it up. Really cool stuff. Really cool stuff. We'll be right back.